Hello guys, Zolid here with a brand new video, and today I will be reviewing set number 75243, Slave 1 20th Anniversary Set. This is a LEGO Star Wars set that came out in April of 2019. This set has 1,007 pieces, and as I said, retails for $120. So let's take a look at the figures. So the first figure we have here is Han Solo, looking nice and snazzy. He has his nice leather jacket here, his OG blaster, and his nice printed pants. He has the usual Han Solo hairpiece, and also he has some back printing, but no leg printing. His face is a double-sided face, so I can take his hair off. He has the smug little look, and then he has a more stern look there. So it's a nice figure to get. Next figure, which is the main draw to this set, I would say, one of the main draws, the 20th anniversary Princess Leia figure. This is a really nice figure I like, and it's really cool. So if you're collecting all of these, I do have all of these, but if you're collecting them, then you have to buy this set to get this layout. Overall, it's a good figure. We have this front printing, trying to replicate the figure all the way back from 1999, I'm pretty sure it was. I do not remember when the original version of this figure came out. She has a 20th anniversary printed on her back, and she has no other face besides her front one, and then she has the plaque with the Princess Leia on it. That's a nice figure to get as well. The next, I don't know if you would call it a figure, is Han Solo and Carbonite. This is a nice thing to get because we really don't get this usually. I mean, last set the set was in was the Cloud City. Cloud City is like $350 if you're not able to get it on a good sale. I sadly did not get Cloud City when it was on like super sale on Amazon. I should have. I never did though. I didn't click buy now. And what happened was I was hoping to get it the next day, but the deal was gone when I woke up. And I really regret that. I'll probably end up buying it off like eBay or something. Maybe I might buy it off Facebook Marketplace because I don't want to deal with a lot of money for shipping. So I might just try to find it on Facebook Marketplace for pickup near my house and just buy it off there like that. But overall, this is a nice figure overall. And I mean, the cheapest way to get it right now, I guess, would be the Carbon Freezing Chamber if you can find it on Bricklink or eBay. But next figure. Next figure is Boba Fett himself. This is a nice figure to get. He has his blaster here, and he has his usual printing for a Boba Fett figure. Really detailed printing. I really like Boba Fett. Boba Fett is probably my favorite Star Wars character, honestly. He is really cool. He has this cape piece for his shoulder here, and he has just a normal printing. On the sides, he has this blue printing here. It's not really printing, but it's just matching his pants color. On the back, he has no leg printing, but he does have a torso, a back print, if you can see a little bit of it, which I have no idea why. I mean, that's why he has a jetpack. But looking at the helmet here, I have the camera focuses. Here we go. It is binged up just like Boba Fett's head. And of course, he has a clone face because he is a clone. Boba Fett did adopt him. Next figure here is Forlom, I'm pretty sure it is. This figure is a cool figure. It comes with this big blaster, this long blaster. He has the nice front printing and a nice leg printing. He has no printing on the sides here. On the back, he has nice printing and no leg printing. This is the same figure that we got in the Bounty Hunter Battle Pack a few years back, which I do have. I just sold. I don't know why I sold it, but yeah, it's a nice figure, and I really like it. And I think that it's a nice inclusion in this set. And then the last figure, which is also a pretty big draw to this set, is the Zuckus. This is our first rendition of Zuckus as a Lego minifigure. Here we have this nice exclusive print and mold for his head. We have nice printing for his legs, and he has some back printing and even some like leg printing. Overall, I think they did a good job with Zuckus. Going forward with the build, this is the Slave One itself, and I think this is a really, really nice model. I got this for Christmas, but I think it's a really nice model, honestly. The wing, these things fold once you pick it up, which I will show in a little, but let's do with the play features here. So over here, this lid opens up. It's a little lid, and you can slide Pencil and Carbonite right into it and then close it up like that. I think that's a nice little inclusion if you have the Cloud City set and you're trying to reenact episode 5. So you can just put Han and Carbonite. Then over here we have just movable blasters here. So when he lands, you can put them like this, or you can put them like this, but I put them like this when it lands. And then when I bring it up, I put it in like that. Over here, you can move these, but they move themselves. I'll show you once I pick this thing up. Then we have these pieces again. I lose these especially a lot. I actually was missing one, so I had to borrow this piece from my ATAP, which is funny. But over here, we have these big pieces, these big molds. So I guess this is why this set is so expensive. These are stickers up here. Going to the side here, to the front, my bad. Here is some more stickers over here. They use some really nice red pieces. And they have a cockpit. And so you can fit Boba Fett in there. Let me get him. Also, another thing, you can take Boba Fett's blaster and also put in that little cockpit place where you could put Han Solo and Carbonite. When you put him in, I suggest that you put his range finder to the side like that, because then it usually falls out when you try to put in the cockpit. But anyways, you put him in there, right? And he stands up like that, and then you put on the cockpit. And there you go. You have Boba Fett inside your Slave One. Then, when you pick this set up, Boba Fett's chair moves. So as you can see, it moves up like that, and then moves up like that. So I think that's a really nice inclusion. You can also see that there's some stickers and a little panel piece right there, a little slope. When you open this, of course, these things fold to the side. So when you land, these things are like that, and then when you pick it up, these things move to the side a little. As you can see, that one didn't really move to the side, but they are supposed to move to the side. There you go, move to the side. Back here is the hyperdrive and stuff. I think they did a pretty good job with this as well. They also have this thing, which I guess you can put the guns on, and I did not notice that until now, actually, so that's pretty cool. I thought you were always supposed to put it inside the little cockpit thing there, but you can put it in the back on those clips. Over here is actually a really cool thing about this set. It's a handle, of all things, a handle for this set. So you pull it out like that, and then you can hold it with one arm. Let me show you. I'm holding the camera on, but there you go. Can hold it up with one arm and shoot it around, which I think is a really nice idea for this set. They have these little clip pieces here. I do not know why, I guess for landing here. And then if you pull these, the flick fire missiles go out. And that's about all the play features and things for the set. So I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. And also, I'll try to make an effort to upload more reviews like this. I'm gonna try 2 reviews a week, hopefully. I can try to do that. Also, sorry for the delay with Agent Class week 1. I have finished week 1. But I forgot to upload the video. I did record it on Friday, so it will be coming out later today, I think, or maybe tomorrow. I don't know. I have to render it in. But hope you guys enjoy this video, and stay tuned for Audra Class. And then also I might have an unboxing video this week, because I have some Bricklink orders coming in. I'm excited. I haven't ordered off Bricklink in a real long time. But hope you guys enjoyed. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.